In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool combination of a wall and railing inside of Revit. This is actually what they have on my balcony, and I thought it was an interesting Revit challenge. Now, I'm going to be showing you everything separately, how to build the wall sweep, the rails, so two different types of rails, and also the balusters, and then bring it all together into this railing. So, let's go! Now, before we jump into Revit, I would just quickly like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got over 140 hours of content, and if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the place to be. Also there you can find some of my ready-to-go Revit templates, some really high-quality parametric Revit families, and we also have a plugin. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and what we'll do first is model the wall family. So for that, let's go here to Architecture, to Wall, and then I'm just going to pick out the first basic wall family here, and I'm just going to go into Edit Type, and what I'll do here is I'm just going to duplicate this and call it our railing wall. So this will be now a new family, and I'm also going to change the material to gypsum wallboard. Click OK, and then let's go and place it. So I'm just going to place it in kind of a U shape here. Let's go 1500 by 4000 millimeters by another 1500 millimeters. Okay, now let's go to the 3D view just to see what that looks like. Obviously it's too tall, so let's select it, and then I'm just going to change the unconnected height to 400 millimeters. Hit apply, and this is what we have now. Okay, so for the next step, we want to add some sort of a sweep on top of this wall. So I want to add kind of a stone finish on top of the wall to protect that wall and also just to look nice. For that, we have to create a family, so a sweep profile family. So for that, let's go here to File, then let's go to New, Family. And here you want to pick out either English or English metric, and then I'm going to search for the metric profile family or family template. Then I'm just going to open this up, and as soon as it opens up, you simply want to zoom into the center here, go to lines, and then place a simple rectangle here. So once we have that rectangle in place, we can turn off the thin lines. We can set the height to be something like 30 millimeters, and then the distance here, I want it to be half of a wall plus a little bit. Actually 115 works really well. In total, that's 230, I think. Yeah. Okay, now I also want to chamfer the edge a little bit, so for that let's go here to Create, go to Line, and then I'm just going to go from middle at a 45 degree angle, and then I can just fix it up like so. Also I'm going to delete this side here, just like that, select these two lines, go to Mirror, pick Access, and then I'm just going to mirror it to the other side, and finish it like that. Okay, so once we have this family, let's then go ahead and save it. So just go here to the save icon, and then search for the folder, name it, and click here to save. Once we have that saved, we can now load it into the project and close up this family. So once it's loaded in, you want to go to the 3D view and then select one of the wall segments, go into Edit Type, and then here let's go into Preview just so we can see that preview, and this might be a bit too big, so let me just make this a bit smaller. Okay, so here we have that wall preview, and I like to set it to section like that. Then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go here into structure, click on edit, and then we can add sweeps here. So here for this sweep, I'm going to include one sweep. I'm going to set the profile to that new wall sweep profile that we have created. For the material, I'm going to pick out a stone material. So here, let's search for, or let's go here to the library and search for stone. And actually, I'm going to pick out this one. So let's load it in and click OK. So once we have the material set up, you also want to set it to be on top, and then just hit apply just to see where that is. So as you can see, it's over here, but it's kind of off to the side. So you want to bring it back in by the kind of half value of the wall thickness, which is 100. So just type in here minus 100 at an offset, hit apply, and that looks good now. Hit okay, okay, and okay. And now we have that sweep applied on top. It actually looks really, really well. I'm quite happy with this result. Okay, so now it's time to create our railing. So for the railing, first we want to create all of the elements of the railing. And for that, what you'll do is go here to File, go to New, and we have to first create three different families. So for the first one, it's going to be a baluster family. So let's pick out the baluster family template, click OK, or click open. And here, what I like to do first is just make sure that the height is set to what I'm actually going to be using as a height. In this case, that's going to be 500. So let's open up family types here and set this to 500. Then hit apply. Okay. Then I'm going to switch to front elevation. I'm going to reposition it a little bit, and then I want to add just an additional reference plane here. So for that, let's go to the reference plane tool and place it here. Okay, then let's go to the dimension tool and place one dimension like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times, reposition this to 100 millimeters, and then select the dimension and lock it in place. Now it's time to model the actual baluster. You want to go here to create, go to extrusion, and then I'm just going to go here to name for the reference plane, and you want to pick out the center front back. Click OK, and now it's time to sketch it out. So I'm just going to start off with a rectangle here and perhaps turn on 10 lines just to make it a bit easier to see. And I'm just going to skip this part just because I can show you the dimensions, and then you can do it on your own instead of watching me do it. So once you sketch up the shape, you want to go here to extrusion end, type in minus 20 and extrusion start at 20. Hit apply and then hit finish. And then also you can assign material if you want. I'm just going to go with some aluminum or aluminium depending on where you are from. So let's load that in and click OK. Finally, we want one more segment here to hold the top rail. So for that, let's go to the reference level, zoom in towards the center here, and then I'm just going to go here to create extrusion, and then let's create a circle just like that. Actually, let's make it smaller. So, oops, I didn't want a dimension there. So let's go with 5 millimeters like that. Okay, go back to the front elevation and then just resize it to the top here. You can lock it in place if you want, just like that. And then you can also apply the material. So here I'm just going to go with that aluminium again. And we're done. Now you just want to save this family and name it, obviously. And then I'm going to hit save. And now we can load it into the project and close it. Okay, now let's create the actual rails. So for that, I'm just going to go here to File, New, and then go to Family. Those are actually simpler to make. So you just want to find here the rail profile. So that's this one for the template. And then these are going to be just two simple rectangles. So for the first one, you just want to come in here and go to Align, go to Rectangle, and create a simple rectangle like so. So here I'm going to set this to 10 millimeters, set this side to 10 millimeters as, oops, to 20 millimeters. Yep. And on top, let's go with something like 25. And in total, that's going to then be 50. So once we have this created, now I'm just going to go here to save, pick out the old folder, name it, save it, and then you want to load it into the project and close it. And then we're just going to repeat the same process by going here to File, New, and then Family. And it's basically the same process. In this case, it's for the top rail. So I'm just going to make that kind of as a horizontal rail. So let's go here to Align, Rectangle, create it like that. And then this is going to be perhaps 30, 60 in total. And then for the height, let's go with 15. Now I'm just going to save that too as top rail and load it into the project and close it. Now it's time to finally build that railing. So what you want to do here is go into a level one. You want to zoom in on top of your wall. You want to go here to railing, and then I'm just going to use pick lines to pick out the center of this wall if I can. Let's see. Nope, it's not going to let me. So then let's just use regular lines and follow the wall center line just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times and then just hit finish. So now we can go to the 3D view and we can see we have this railing here placed, and then you want to go to pick new host, and then you want to pick that wall. So it's going to start from that wall and go up. And now it's time for today's Revit secret tip. So when it comes to hosting railing on top of walls in Revit, what's really cool about it is that the wall doesn't have to be straight on top. It doesn't have to be horizontal and it doesn't have to be straight. So here I have this wall, so let's select it and then go into edit profile, and then let's go crazy with a spline on top of that wall. So we're going to have this really unique kind of top surface, and I'm just going to reduce these two down just like that, and let's delete this and then hit finish. So we have this kind of uniquely shaped wall. So now if I go here into level one and then go to railing, and if I want to place railing on top of that and then go back to the 3D view, hit finish. So we have that railing here. If I go to pick new host, if I go to pick new host and select this wall, it's going to host that railing on top of that wall. So you can create some really unique designs by combining railing with a wall where you can edit the profile of that wall and create some interesting shapes. So once we have that there in place, now we can turn this into something a bit more interesting. But first, let's actually switch this to pipe just because it's a bit closer to what we want. Then we're going to go here into edit type. We're going to duplicate this and let's call it our new custom rail. Then you want to click OK. And first, let's change the height from 900 to 500 millimeters. And then you want to go to rail structure, and instead of four rails, I'm just going to get rid of top two. So let's hit delete, delete. And then here for the name, we can leave it as is, but let's just change the profile to our regular rails. So just like that. And then for the material, you can go for aluminium if you want. So I'm just going to pick that out, and then I'm going to copy and paste that here. Okay, so once we have that in place, then here for the top rail, I also want to change its type. So here, come to that, go to the profile, and let's change it to our top rail. Also change the material to aluminium. I've copied it there so I can just paste it here, which I think it's a cool little tip where if you have the name of the material, you can just type it in or paste it in, and it's going to figure out which one it is if it's the correct name. And it's also cap sensitive, so be careful. Click OK there, and now I think we're getting there. So let's actually check the preview. So Revit is going to be showing you a preview here, and this looks good, but we still need to change the balusters. So let's go here to baluster placement, and let's change the balusters here to our baluster that we have created. Hit apply. There we go. So we have that one. Now here at the edges, I actually don't want to have balusters. So I'll show you why when we're done. But here I'm just going to set those all to none. Hit apply. So now we only have this one. And then the distance from previous, I'm going to change that to 800 millimeters. I think that will work. And that should be it. If I hit apply, okay, apply, okay. And this is what we have. So as you can see, it looks really, really good. Only a couple of things that we might want to edit. So let's select this. Let's go here into edit type. And actually for our balusters, we want to make sure that here the justification is set to center. And then hit apply. Okay. And then also let's go here to rail structure and let's bring that bottom rail a little bit up. So let's go here with 150 and this one can go to 350, this one 170. Let's hit apply. Yeah, I think this looks a lot better. Okay. And then this is what we have. So as you can see now, without those corner rails, I think this looks, or corner balusters or posts, I think this looks a lot more elegant. So there we go. It actually looks exactly like the real thing. So that's how you can create this combination of railing and wall inside of Revit. I think it's actually really good to have the bottom modeled as a wall instead of modeled as railing, just because it has kind of more features to join it up with other geometry in Revit. So I think it's really important to pick out that wall family on the bottom instead of using just another rail profile for this wall. So there you go. If you want to download this Revit project file, you can find it on my Patreon page where you can actually find all of my Revit project files. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.